My name's Terrance Masson. I'm the newly minted founder and CEO of Building Conversation, Inc. So recently finished about 7 years teaching full-time at Northeastern University as head of animation and founding director of creative industries and things like that. It actually came out of a student-led project, a senior capstone project, and it's a partner of mine, George Thrush, who's the head of the architecture department at Northeastern. So we did, it's augmented reality for architectural visualization. So location-based, mobile, and we started about 3 years ago. So luckily I've got about a 3-year ramp up to the new great thing. It's nice to be ahead of the game again. And it's a blast. We've been doing beta testing and it's developing the software and part of a service company, but we're focused exclusively on architecture. So, you know, data-driven visualizations on site. So you can go walk around and look through the window of your iPad at the real world with the overlaid full-size hologram of the designs that are just exported directly from what these firms already use. So it's pretty seamless and easy and a blast. So our clients are the architecture firms. And the great surprise to me is that every firm is just slightly different. So it solves one of two or three different problems. Either it's design iteration. So if you're a designer at an architecture firm, you can actually go out on site and you can iterate quicker because you can see all the contingencies and you can iterate on site instead of just looking at a flat screen or, you know, a foam core model. So that's one. The other is marketing sales. So a high-end private design firm that's marketing to an individual will have an edge over their competition, basically, to have their client come out on set with them and actually show them and say, well, do you like the pool in the front or the side or, you know, wood siding or bricks? And you can click all through that. And it's quite a rush. It's kind of surreal to actually see this virtual thing through the window of the iPad. Well, exactly. And it's a nice natural extension from the production side of virtual filmmaking, right? So it's like it's the opposite of a green screen shoot. Now, the real world is real and you're putting in the digital asset, but you're seeing them seamlessly integrated in real time, right, through your iPad. And, you know, clicking through options and doing things like that. Or having a survey mode in the case of a downtown controversial, you know, urban development thing where you can push the app out for free through the app store and people can comment on a survey level. Like we're pitching to the Olympic Committee. We have the 2024 group in Boston. We're trying to do the Summer Olympics. So we have all the perspective venues in the city modeled and placed latitude, longitude very precisely. So you push out a free app, get a QR code to download them from the cloud, and anybody in any neighborhood can look around and go, oh crap, I had no idea they were going to propose a, you know, stadium across my street. You know, and that's how big it is and it blocks my sight to the, you know, blah, blah, blah. Anyway. I've always been a closet architect fan. I remember as early as high school taking architecture courses. There's just a beauty and a simplicity about, you know, the history of it and the cultural differences. So what's not to love about architecture, right? But having my partner be, you know, he's been in architecture as long as I've been in interactive media and CG and animation. So we're a great pairing for that. And you probably know, I get bored easy. You know, maybe every decade it's like, well, you know, I've done flying logos and visual effects and feature animation and special venue ride films, you know, et cetera, et cetera. So it's nice to be able to leapfrog to something a little bit different for content, but kind of capitalizing on it. It's a great mixture of creative technology and business, you know, doing my own bootstrap startup from scratch. So, you know, spent 25 years building companies for other people. So why not do my own for a change? So we incorporated last year. Been beta testing for about almost 3 years now, actually. So we've got a good beta client list. So big architecture firms like Gensler, Payette, Sasaki. And we're going to leverage all of that hopefully as early as the fall. And we really need to start looking at some angel investment, mainly to accelerate, not to necessarily scale for its own sake. But I see this as a very clear disruptive technology, buzzword, you know, in the entrepreneurship. Disruptive technology. Somebody's going to do this and somebody's going to do it quick. So I'm going to get steamrolled by somebody else, either another startup or a big player who puts a lot of attention on this kind of specific market. And I just want to get there first. So, so we're evaluating the company and, you know, talking to angels and getting a team ready to come on board and move everything locally into Boston because it's a great community.